In this video, I'm talking about that annoying sound that some people get from their hearing aids called feedback and how to get rid of it. Coming up. Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Phoenix, Arizona. And on this channel, I cover a bunch of hearing related information to help make you a better informed consumer. So if you're into that, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Chances are that either you or someone you know who wears hearing aids has experienced that annoying whistling sound called feedback. Now, feedback is basically the endless cycling of sound coming out of a speaker and then going back through the microphone, which emits a really high frequency whistle. You may have also experienced feedback by going to a public venue where someone is up on stage talking with a microphone. If they walk around that stage and they get too close to the speaker that's on that stage, you end up getting feedback as well. So what specifically causes feedback with hearing aids? Well, there are 10 common causes, and the first common cause of feedback with hearing aids is that you are not putting the hearing aids in your ears correctly. When your hearing care professional fits you with a pair of hearing aids, they are programming the amplification of those hearing aids to your prescription with that hearing aid being in its proper location. So if you're wearing it like this, you would likely be okay. However, if you're not getting the hearing aid dome or ear mold inside of your ear correctly and it looks more like that, then you're likely going to be experiencing feedback. The second cause of feedback is an improper physical fit. So if you do wear your hearing aids correctly like I am right now, but you actually have the wrong type of dome on the end of that hearing aid or the wrong ear mold vent size, then sound will be able to leak out of your ear canal and recycle back through the microphone, which, yes, will cause feedback. Third is too much compression. Now, compression can be a complicated subject for some individuals, and I do have another video that I will link in the description that explains compression in detail, but think of it like this. We need to be applying more amplification to soft level sounds so you can actually hear them. But if we overly compress these sounds and make them too loud, then these sounds can actually leak outside of your ear canal and recycle back through the microphones, causing feedback. The fourth cause is earwax. If you have a bunch of excessive earwax building up inside of your ear canals, then amplified sound can reflect off of that earwax outside of your ear canal and potentially recycle back through the microphones. Fifth is not having a strong enough feedback management system inside of your hearing aid programming. Most of the major hearing aid manufacturers have really good feedback management systems, and these management systems will either limit the amount of amplification in the frequency ranges that feedback would occur in, or it actually emits a counteracting sound wave to cancel out feedback before it actually occurs. However, if this is not set up during your hearing aid fitting, or it's not set to a strong enough of a level, then it could increase the likelihood that you experience feedback. Sixth is the shrinking of a behind-the-ear hearing aid tube. So if you're someone who wears a BTE like this one, that thick tube that goes down inside of an ear mold can potentially shrink. And when it does, it can create a gap between the ear mold and that tube, creating leakage of sound, which could cause feedback. It also potentially could shrink to the point where it actually pulls the ear mold outside of your ear, again, making a gap where that sound doesn't get retained inside of your ear and again causes feedback. The seventh cause is your receiver wires being too short. So if you have a receiver in canal hearing aid, which are some of the most popular hearing aids out there today, if the wire on that hearing aid is too short, it ends up pulling on the actual dome that's inside of your ears, creating a gap, which again causes feedback. Reason number eight is that your ear canal size has actually changed. Now this occurs as you get older. So if you have a hearing aid ear mold that is like 10 years old, then there is a good chance that there's a bunch of sound leaking out from around that ear mold. But this can also occur more suddenly for individuals who drop a bunch of weight. So if you've been on a weight loss program, or if you have the unfortunate circumstance of going through some kind of an illness where you dropped a bunch of weight quickly, this can definitely cause a leakage of sound, which again can cause feedback. Reason number nine is a crack in your tubing or your ear mold. So if there's any leakage of sound, I think I've gotten this point across at this point. If there's any leakage of amplified sound coming out of your ears or leaking out of the hearing aid anywhere, this sound can recycle back through the microphones and cause feedback. Number 10 is the acoustic leakage of sound inside of a hearing aid. Now, everything up until this point has basically been there's sound leaking outside of your ear canal to cause that feedback. Well, this is when sound isn't leaking outside of your ear canal. Sound is leaking inside of the actual hearing aid, and that leakage of sound can actually vibrate the microphone and cause feedback. Okay, so as you can tell, there are a ton of things that can cause feedback with hearing aids. So what do you do to actually prevent this annoying whistling sound announcing to the world that you're wearing hearing aids that aren't working correctly? Well, correcting feedback is actually pretty easy. The first thing that you need to do is make sure that you have your hearing aids inserted inside of your ear canals correctly. If you do and the feedback goes away, then you've solved the problem. Now, if you've gotten them inside of your ear canals and the problem is still there and you're still experiencing feedback, then you may actually need to get a hold of your hearing care provider. The first step that your hearing care provider will usually do is take a look inside of your ear canals to see if there's any earwax. Of course, if there is, they should be able to remove that earwax. And if that was the cause of it, then the feedback will go away immediately. If that doesn't fix it, they will move on to step number two, which is making a visual inspection of your hearing aids to make sure that there's no cracks or breaks or anything like that on the hearing aid itself, causing a potential leakage of sound. Of course, if there is, they will fix whatever that problem is, either in office or by sending that hearing aid back to the manufacturer to have them fix it if it's something they can't do in office. If the feedback was not being caused by a broken ear mold or a crack in the tubing or a ripped dome, then it's time to move on to step number three, which is checking for internal feedback. They can check for internal feedback by simply plugging the receiver with their finger, and if they hear any feedback occurring, they know that it's something internal to the hearing aid. However, you may also have to stick it into a hearing instrument test box to test for internal feedback. If internal feedback is identified, then that hearing aid has to go back to the manufacturer because there's a broken component inside of the device. If the feedback is not being caused internally, then it's time to move on to step number four, which is checking the programming of the hearing aids. Sometimes your hearing care professional can activate like an adaptation manager, which will increase amplification over time as you get used to that amplification, but that can increase volume to the point where some of that sound can leak out of your ear canals. They may even choose to run the feedback manager again to see where this leakage of sound is occurring, and then maybe even increase the strength of the feedback reduction system to eliminate the feedback. If those things don't fix it, then you only have one other step to take, and that is step number five, which is you have to change the dome or the ear molds on your hearing aids. If you cannot eliminate feedback by making a repair of a hearing aid or enabling a stronger feedback reduction system or reducing amplification, then you have to be able to trap more sound inside of the ear canal and prevent it from leaking out. And that requires you having maybe a larger dome or an ear mold that is fit better. Now, if you choose to go this route of trapping more sound inside of your ear canal, there can be trade-offs with this. If you're someone who has good low frequency hearing and you put a completely occluding dome inside of your ear canal or a completely occluding ear mold inside of your ear canal where it doesn't allow any leakage of sound at all, then you may experience the occlusion effect, which is where your own voice sounds really boomy and loud to yourself because the vibration of your voice through your jaw and into your ear canal can't escape. This is why it's so important to work with your hearing care professional to identify the right type of dome and ear mold with the proper venting so you don't experience the occlusion effect and you also don't experience feedback. Well, congratulations, because you now know just about everything there is to know about feedback and how to get rid of it, except for one thing. And that is, you should experience some amount of feedback when you're putting your hearing aids inside of your ears and when you're pulling them out of your ears, because until you get the hearing aid in the exact right spot, there's going to be some leakage of sound, so don't freak out. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you like the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Also, feel free to check out my website, drcliffaud.com.